terms of being pro, you got to be the Google of the Googles to go pro. So I'm going to ask the fellas, why is it that most athletes 3 to 5 years after they leave sports are bankrupt? They're bankrupt. Why?
They're bankrupt because they don't invest in anything about like spending money and stuff.
Give me another reason. That's a good one.
Not investing in the money world.
That's a good reason. The real reason, those are good. They don't understand where their money is. They will typically have someone that they cannot relate to, and they say, because Joe used them, I'm going to use you. Take care of it.
So are you like similar to like an accountant?
I do. I'm going to tell you the things that we do. Finance and business, the lifeblood, like the blood in your body, is accounting. Anything you do in business is based on accounting. Wonderful career. The best of the best are what we call CPAs, certified public accountants. Okay? Every major corporation in this paper have entire financial departments with tons of accountants. If you put together a business deal and you issue new stock, like Google, there are accountants in the room. There are also lawyers in the room. They're called security lawyers. Okay? They got pinstripes too. So accounting, career-wise, CPAs. Securities, lawyers. They deal with bonds, they issue securities, any major deal that goes on Wall Street, lawyers and accountants are there. Okay? What a CFP does, estate planning. Requires lawyers. Basically, you work and work and work, you create wealth. There's some interesting dynamics. Ultimately, we die. You guys got 60, 70 years of wonderful life ahead of you. 80 years, 90 years with modern medicine. You're going up, accumulating wealth over time. James, at his age, I'm old. I will be spending that wealth until some magic point when I die. To transfer wealth, that's what we call estate planning. In our community, most of our community, we don't have living trusts or do estate planning. That's unfortunate. Another day, I'll go into more details on that. The next thing we do, retirement planning. Okay, retirement planning includes a whole bunch of stuff, but basically, as you make money, take a chunk of it, save it, and invest it so that it grows like that red line. But it requires you to pay attention to what your advisors are doing and learning the language of business. The language of business. And it all boils down to accounting. Debits and credits. Cash in, cash out. The next thing we do as CFPs, tax planning. We work very closely with accountants. And the issue about tax planning is this. It's not about how much you make, it's how much you keep. Because Uncle Sam, see these guys on the front page? Congress, they're the biggest crooks on the planet. The bottom line is, out of the 70 to 80,000 lines of tax code, how do you take advantage of the tax code to get the biggest deductions and not pay as much tax as somebody else? There's a Second Circuit Court judge that said something to the effect, I'll paraphrase, those who are informed, paying taxes are optional. Those who are uninformed, paying taxes are mandatory. Okay? The next thing we do, what we call risk management. Risk management, that's a fancy word for detours and insurance. If I have a car accident today, I got car insurance that will fix my car. To get car insurance after an accident is kind of useless, because you got to use your cash, because they won't insure a prior accident. Okay? So when we look at risk management, we look at things that could detour your plans. And this is financial analysis. So as a certified financial planner, that's what I do for a living. All six stages. Okay? Again, I can talk for days. Now, how much time do I have left in this session?
4 minutes.
4 minutes. My name is James Towns. I'm a certified financial planner. I went to Hamilton College. This is in Clinton, New York, upstate New York. I majored in economics. I got some certifications from UCLA. One of the things about this profession, you're constantly learning. So in 2012, my last institution was UCLA, upon which I got the CFP certification. Okay? Constantly learning, constantly reading, constantly keeping up with what's going on in the world of business. Questions?
Mr. Tom, you know, my sister, she's a CPA.
Yes.
So you're also a CPA?
I'm not a CPA.
Oh, what's the difference between CPA and CFP?
They are strictly in the accounting world.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
They get certified for public accounting. We study tax, but we're looking at how to use the tax code to reduce and to increase, reduce your tax bill, mm-hmm. transfer wealth to future generations, mm-hmm. and using the tax code help increase your investment profile.
Very interesting.
So we work very closely with CPAs.
What made you want to be a CPA?
I will say I went through a whole slew of activities. I worked many years ago in technology companies, managed the Western states. The issue associated with technology is constantly changing. Love technology, but it wasn't providing any value. So what's the difference between an iPhone 8 and an iPhone 10? It doesn't matter, who cares? It still does what you need it to do, right? Okay, so technology in and of itself wasn't satisfying enough. This, I help people. I help people put a bright light on things that they don't understand. I love teaching people about the market. I love sharing knowledge about this stuff and helping folks make money. That's what I like doing. Okay? Other questions? Before the bell rings, please.
How long have you been working here?
I've been doing this for 14 years. Okay? Before that, I was in technology. Before that, I was in accounting for General Electric. Many years ago.
Mr. Towns, but would you agree that in order for them to get there, first thing is college, right? They must go to college.
There are three things I'm going to tell you. Where was my Google? You got to be the best of the best. You definitely have to have a college degree to be a CFP. You have to have the best history. When I say history, no bankruptcies, no tax liens, no felonies, no arrests, etc. Because if you're dealing with other people's money, you gotta be clean. Yes, sir?
Do
Any degree from college, so bachelor's degree, a little bit? Or
bachelor's degree, you can go up to PhD in some of this stuff. If you move up the securities ladder, and just securities, you got hedge fund managers that are making in excess of billions of dollars a year and are not taxed at the rate that everybody in this room would be taxed at. So, you can get a PhD in finance or accounting. You get master's in any of these. Getting an MBA, a master's of business administration. And if you go, you're gonna be the Googles. You're gonna go to Harvard, Stanford, Princeton,
yes.
Dartmouth, Yale, Columbia, University of Chicago,
University of Texas,
UCLA, USC, okay. But I'm talking Ivy League to be the best of the best.
Mr. Parker, you might, adding to what you said, my sister did go to UNC. Don't be afraid of getting in debt. When my sister decided to go to UNC, I thought, what is she? She got a student loan, so it doesn't matter. Just do it. And that's all she has. She has her bachelor's from UNC, so she went to that Ivy school.
Bottom line, there's good debt and bad debt. College education, good debt. Buying a brand new muscle car, bad debt.
Is there a balcony?
No.
All right, everyone, thank you, Mr. Thomas, please.
Thank you, Mr.
You will need finance.
No problem. No, I said my personal friend. She said uncle.
Maybe from when I'm on authoring books.
See, you will need finance. But when you start, when you have that discovery, you start making tons of money, somebody has to manage that.
Yes.